Hello, my friends. Let's do some yoga for the pelvic floors. So let's begin. As you are seated, feel free to lift the sit bones a little bit away from the floor, make a bit more space for the lower back. You can pop a blanket underneath your bottom. Make sure you're relatively comfortable. And we're just going to feel how your pelvic floor feels at this point in time. So your mind is down in your pelvic floor. So the pelvic floor, you imagine it like a diamond shape. My index fingertips, pointer fingertips, would be the pubic bone at the front, and the thumb tips would be the tailbone at the back. And the pelvic floor, we want it kind of looking down towards the floor so that the pubic bone isn't tipped up and tailbone down. Maybe just take that pubic bone a little bit more forward and down to give a nice base for you to sit on. And then the muscles of the back and the side legs can relax. Finding good solid base is really important for pelvic floor function and health. And then do that again. Tip onto your tailbone. Feel how the pelvic floor is lifted up. And then pubic bone down. And tailbone is slightly lifting up behind you. So see how much backward tilt you can get in your pelvis and how much forward tilt. And just continue that. I'll give you the view from the side so you're quite clear. Tailbone is tucked under. I'm resting onto the bottom of my spine. The weight pressing into the floor. Pubic bone heavy at the front, coming down between thighs to the floor. And my tailbone is light and lifted and free off the mat. Tuck. And then free the tail. And then free the tail. So in that diamond, we also have the side edges of the diamond. That's your sit bones that you're sitting on. So feel them. Let's rotate into a nice round circle, taking the weight over to one sit bone and then over to the other. The knees can lift if that helps you to get more clarity of where those bony protrusions are. And coming back to center. Feel that you can center yourself. Your diamond of the pelvic floor is facing the earth. And then above that is your belly, heart, and head. Can we maintain it as we swing our legs around and line our back? So this is taking weight off the pelvic floor. That's why a lot of pelvic floor work, first thing you do is line the back. Hands close in to the side of the body. We're going to tilt the pelvis back. So think of your diamond of the pelvic floor and think fingertips at the top is the pubic bone. So now the pubic bone has squeezed in towards the navel. And then release the other way, pubic bone away from the belly, and the belly stretches. Lift the pubic bone, curl it, navel towards spine. Pubic bone away, belly towards ceiling. Continue forward and backward tilts of your pelvis. Notice what you feel. Notice the structures of the body. And then release to neutral and rest. So now we're going to exhale, draw navel to spine, to squeeze that breath all the way out of the body. And then inhale, belly swells and floats up. Not tilting the hips at the moment, just feeling again that we can exhale and actually flatten the lower abdominal area by squeezing just below the navel, down towards the spine. And then inhale. Exhale, draw navel to spine, tuck the tail this time and really squeeze the breath out. And then inhale, release your pelvis to a neutral position. Exhale, squeeze navel to spine, tuck the tail. Inhale, neutral. Relax the pelvic floor, relax the hips, the buttocks, everything. Exhale, tuck. And inhale, release to a neutral spine. Take the soles of the feet together, open the knees wide, and now you really feel the pelvic floor is very open. If your knees are quite high or tight in the groin, please use supports underneath. Anything that you have, pillows, blankets, pop them underneath for support, or yoga blocks could be good too. So to demonstrate, that would be under the thigh on both sides, as evenly as you can get. Okay, so suppose it's really important to feel, particularly the front of the pelvic floor, open, any sensation with the openness of the belly. And then release, bend the knees, stick to the mat, palm stays down close to the side of the body. Make sure your pelvis is neutral, not forward or backward tilted. We're going to inhale, press into the feet and lift the hips, and exhale to lower. So just check that movement is okay for you. Neutral pelvis, neutral spine, lifting and lowering. Lift a little less if it is quite challenging. Okay, so let's try one way. We're going to exhale, navel to spine, tilt the pelvis back, flattening your lower back into the floor. Continue the pressing into the floor through mid-back, upper back, lift the pelvis, and then slowly mid-back down, lower back down, pelvis down, and release completely. Inhale. Exhale, navel to spine, tilt the pelvis back, tailbone's floating up. Pelvis floats up, roll up through the spine. Keep this backward tilt of the pelvis, even as you lower down, so you're really getting the flattening action of the small of your back into the floor. Bend when it's down, then release neutral pelvis. Once more, exhale, tilt back, navel to spine, lift the hips, and gently lower down as you inhale. Release, soles of the feet together, open the knees wide, close the eyes and rest. Silence.